One day our pastor came to me and said, "Sister, would you like to go to New Guinea with me? Two of us are going." And I said, "I'm really not interested in going to New Guinea. What I'd like to do would be to go to Rome while I'm young enough to enjoy it." Now it quit going on?
Yep. It just goes down when your voice isn't really loud. So okay. It's on. It's fine.
Okay. However, so about a couple months later, I was called to the pastor's office, and he said, "Sister, I can give you a round trip ticket to Rome, all expenses paid. How does that sound? You get the permission." I thought, "Oh, I'll never get the permission for that. I'm teaching school. How would I ever do that?" Finally, he said, "You get the permission." Well, it took a little while, and finally I wrote the letter and asked if it was possible to go to Rome. All expenses would be paid, and I would be going to represent the parish at the ordination of Father Kent Kaufman. Finally, I got the permission. Before I left, Father said to me, "Do you have anything special you want to do in Rome?" I said, "Well, really, I've got 5 things I want to do." He said, "What are they?" "Number 1, shake hands with the Pope." "Oh, sister, you can't do that. You don't plan on it. You're going to be very disappointed. Only 1 in a million has that opportunity." "Father, why couldn't I be that one?" He said, "Oh, you're going to be disappointed. What else do you want?" I said, "I want a trip to Assisi from Rome." "Well, that's possible. I want to go to the ordination of Kent Kaufman. I also would like to go to the catacombs of St. Agnes. And the third, last thing, I want to attend midnight mass at Christmas." He said, "I think the 4 things ought to be possible, but don't be disappointed. You will not shake hands with the Pope." Okay, so I went to Rome. They asked me what I was, anything special I wanted. And I said, "Well, Father told me I would never have an opportunity to shake hands with the Pope, but I would like to do that if I could." Well, they couldn't promise me that either. So I told them about my 5 things that I wanted.
And did you want to go to the midnight mass too? Wasn't that
I would say Christmas.
Oh.
Yeah. I mentioned that, didn't I?
Okay.
Yeah. And so I informed them that one thing I wanted to do was to, of course, go to the ordination of Kent Kaufman for the reason I went there. And they said, "Yes, that's possible." Then they said, "What else?" I said, "I want midnight mass at Christmas." "Wait a minute, sister, we have midnight mass right here at the convent." And our convent was about 5 miles from the city of Rome. "And we only have 1 car. There's 60 sisters here, and we have midnight mass, so there's no point in going there." I said, "But I want it in Rome. I want it at St. Peter's. I want it with a Pope." They said, "I have my doubts." "What else do you want?" "I want a trip to Assisi." They said, "Well, that's possible." "What else?" "I want a trip to the catacombs of St. Agnes." "Sister, that's way outside the city of Rome. I mean, we've got catacombs right here in Rome under St. Peter's you can go to. But St. Agnes is outside the city of Rome. We would never be able to get there." I said, "Well, I also would like to go to Assisi, to midnight mass, to this ordination, I think I've included them all."
Okay,
I said, "So I get to there and we start. The first day I'm there, we do have a general audience from the Holy Father. About 40,000 were present, and we were sitting in a side place where the Pope looked about 2 inches tall going down the aisle. Of course, I didn't shake hands with him. A few days later, we had a private audience with the Holy Father, with the boys that were going to be ordained, and also their families. I was included in their families. Now, a private audience doesn't mean that you and the Pope are together. It means that you and the group, so there were about 300 of us in that private audience. Before the before it began, Kent Kaufman, the person I went for, came back to where I was sitting and called me to the middle aisle. I want to speak to you. And I said, what do you want? He said, I want you to sit right here on the aisle. And then he whispered, the Pope, when he's finished with us, the deacons, comes back and shakes hands with the end one in every pew. And I want you to have that opportunity. Believe it or not, by my third day there, I had the opportunity of shaking hands with the Pope. The following few days later, I was at the ordination. Of course, it was making them deacons, not the final ordination, but they were making them deacons. There were 29 men who were going to become deacons in Rome at St. Peter's from Canada and the United States. And their families could all be there. So there were about 300 of us there at this Mass and this celebration. So I was there for this, which I really enjoyed having this happen at St. Peter's. Although it was in one of the off chapels of St. Peter's, it wasn't in the big church. And then as we went on, I said, I'm hoping that we get a chance to go to Assisi. And the day of his ordination, Kent came to me and said, Sister, now I want to tell you that tomorrow my parents are taking us to Assisi. So we got in a train and we all went to Assisi and we were there for the whole day. What a beautiful experience. And when we got home, we decided, and what's going to happen next? Well, we decided to have a write out an itinerary where we were going to go on the next day. And we had about 15 places we were going to stop. Everything written out and where we were going first. And we did it all by bus. And so we had a bus ticket that would take us from one to another, one bus to another, wherever we were going. And so we were waiting at the corner for the bus. And my partner said, now, if we were going to the catacombs of St. Agnes, we would take this bus 85, but we're not going. And I waited till the bus got up to our corner. And I turned around and I said, yes, we are. And I jumped in and she had to come with me. All the while out there, she said, I just want to tell you, we spent yesterday planning the whole itinerary for today. Now that we're going out to the catacombs of St. Agnes, I think the bus makes one trip out there a day. What time we get home tonight, I don't know. You're not going to see a thing that we planned all day. We have to do that another time if we get it in at all. But it's going to take forever to get out there. And then you have to wait and wait and wait when you're there to be able to have a tour, because they have to have at least 15 to 20 people want to make the tour down through the catacombs. And you have to wait, and that might be late this afternoon. And then we have to wait for a bus that would take us back. Our day is shot. Okay, but we are on the bus going to the catacombs of St. Agnes. We get there. And they were just ready to have a mass, a wedding mass, go on in the chapel. But alongside of it, it says tours here. So I rapped at the door and I said, how long would we have to wait to have a tour of the catacombs? They said, we're starting right now. Step in. So we stepped in, got in line. We went right straight around every place. And I was found out that St. Agnes in that catacombs was also buried with someone else, and I don't recall who it is because it was time of persecution. And she is the only one that had a light lit at her grave. And she also had flowers around there. and a prie-dieu in front where we could kneel and pray for a while. Well, that was a dream come true because I never expected to be able to go to the catacombs. So as we're leaving, Sister said, you know, I don't know what we're going to do all day here because we probably won't get a bus till tonight. And I walked out and I said, there's bus 85. We walked out, jumped in the bus. It was zipped right back to Rome. And we were able to cover 14 of the 15 places we had planned for that day. The only place we didn't reach was the special stairs. And I was too tired for it anyway, because those were the stairs that you went up on your knees. And by this time, I was too tired to go on my knees anyplace. So I felt we could skip the stairs and I wouldn't be missing too much. So that was that day. So we get back to Rome and we're ready for, did I give Christmas yet?
No.
And we are ready for Christmas. And the day before Christmas, one of the sisters said, you know, this is my last year here in Rome, and I've been here about 15 years. I'm secretary to a cardinal. I wish I would have, in one of those years, made arrangements to go to the midnight mass at Christmas. Now, you don't have to pay to go, but you can't go without a ticket, and you have to require the ticket some weeks in advance, or at least some time in advance. So one of the sisters was telling me about this. She really was from the United States, from Iowa. She was not from our community, but she lived there because there were no other sisters of her community that lived in Rome. So she boarded with us. And I had breakfast with her the day before Christmas, and she said, you know, I wish I would have made arrangements for that sometime, but I can't now. It's too late. You have to have a ticket. And I said, Sister, don't worry. There's no way of getting there, even if we had the tickets. And I said, because one of the sisters wrote in for tickets, and we got the tickets, but there's no way of getting there. She said, what do you mean? I got my own car. I said, you got your car? She said, yes. I said, we got the ticket. So we piled six of us went in the car, and we had six tickets. One sister that was going to go backed out, and she said, I don't want to go. I will be crabby all day on Christmas Day if I go to Midnight Mass. So we ended up by going to Midnight Mass because this sister took us in her private car. It was a wonderful experience. We were there, believe it or not, 9 o'clock at night to get a place. Also, you wanted a program. If you didn't have a program, you were out of luck, because you wouldn't know what's going on. You wouldn't know where to sit. You wouldn't see anything. But we were there early enough that we got in. They directed us to our place. We were the second or third pew in the chapel, but we were off in a side chapel. But we had a perfect view of the Pope and the Mass. Perfect view. He was right within our view. And we were about the third seat back, and the seats were elevated as you go on. We had a perfect view. As we came in there, we also got the whole program, which told us exactly what we're doing, what they're singing, what language they're using, and so on. So I had that wonderful privilege of going to Midnight Mass on Christmas. Needless to say, when my trip was over, I couldn't have been more fulfilled in my desires than I did to be with our sisters for 2 weeks, to be having all these trips, these tours, and seeing everything that my heart desired and that I wanted when I went to Rome. They are the two most memorable weeks of my entire life, and I will never forget them. And there isn't anything that could have taken its place. So I thank you for listening, but it's a memorable, wonderful experience.